Namaskar, I'm Shamapti and I'm so happy to see you. And you see this like glowing skin or oily skin or something like that. This is because I have used quite a few skincare products on my face and I didn't want to wash it or wipe it before shooting because there is 100 rupees on my face right now. And I didn't want to waste the money, so it's gonna be like this. It looks oily. A little bit oily, yeah. I don't know why I'm feeling so conscious today. Anyway, today I have few body care recommendations for you. Amazing, beautiful stuff. And I have one sponsored body care video coming very soon, tomorrow or day after tomorrow or this week, something like that. So I thought of giving you one unsponsored video as well, because it's true that I get paid for those sponsored videos. Still, I won't be lying about those things. Like, if I didn't like certain stuff, I won't go and promote those things. I'm gonna walk away from that campaign. But I understand there are people who cannot trust like sponsored videos. They find unsponsored videos to be more reliable. So for them, I'm gonna have plenty of options. But yeah, just know this thing: if one video is sponsored, doesn't mean that some influencer or content creator is like fundamentally the person is lying. It may be true for some cases, but not true for all the cases. But again, don't feel forced into trusting something you don't want to trust. If you don't like sponsors post, you find paid promotions to be sneaky, that's totally fine. Do not sacrifice your comfort level. And for you, I have to balance out things. So yeah, and that happened with me. You know, I made two hair care sponsored videos and there are people who had issues with that, and I totally get it, because now YouTube is saturated with like sponsored videos and all. And why you would watch a YouTube channel if it does only promote things like they get paid for? Then the channel becomes an ad, nothing else, right? So I get that. But for that only, I made one this 50 or 25 hair care recommendations video that was unsponsored, because I knew I'm gonna do this sponsored video. So I wanted to give you the unsponsored recommendations as well. Maybe there are people who miss that video because YouTube is kind of mean to me sometimes. It doesn't send out the notifications for some videos of mine. So yeah, and just know this: I'm here to make you feel comfortable. I do not want my content to discomfort you. So please feel free to give me your feedbacks. And if you're not comfortable about something about my content, let me know. If I think I can work on that, if I think it's fair for me to work on that, I'll do that. So yeah, it was a like long talk. Okay, so let's start with the body care recommendations. And first, I have body wash, and I have few like ghasi piti recommendations because these things work, you know. There's Johnson & Johnson top to toe wash. This is amazing. If you're looking for gentle body wash, it can be the thing. Even this Himalaya gentle body wash or baby wash. Oh, this is baby wash. These two things are very good if you're looking for an everyday gentle body cleansers that are very affordable. You can go for either of this. These things are gold. And if you're looking for something fancy that scents good, that smells good, I understand after a long day or in the morning, if your shower gel smells good, it can truly lift up your mood. For that, you can try any of this plum ka thing, all this Hawaiian Bloomba. I don't like the smell of it much. This is my most favorite, the smell wise. This is the second favorite. This is the last favorite. This is Tropical Tango. This is Hawaiian Rumba. And this is Driving Me Jerry. I mean, you can go for any body care that, you know, that smells good. Like, there are this Bath and Body thing, a body shop. They make like shower gels that smell awesome, if that is something you want. And lately I bought this one, their Plum Body Loving Shower Cream. Even this is good. I love their vanilla range like more than their other things like cherry or her Roomba line. So I would say skip, if you're looking for something from Plum, skip this one, skip these gels. All right, instead you get this shower cream. This smells awesome. This is more moisturizing, nourishing, cleanses the skin well. But to be very honest, I would just stick to my baby washes, you know. These things work best for me. But if you're looking for something more soothing or gentle, okay, so they're just applauding me for my good recommendations, sarcasm, or just I'm trying to be funny. No, my recommendations are like okay. I'm trying to do better. So yeah, this Bioderma Aturam gel, it can be very good if you have like dry skin, irritated skin. If you want something soothing gel, this is also a very good stuff. You can use this on your face, on your body. So this is also quite good. And then I have another thing. This is I like the packaging very much. This is from this brand, I forgot the name. This is Centico or something like that. I found this on, I don't know, on Myntra or Amazon. So yeah, this is shower cream. This is also quite good. And you can buy this one. Where is this? This one or this one, either of this, because both of these are good and worked really well for my skin. It has SLS though, but I have debunked the myth of SLS many times on my channel. You can watch Lab Muffin Beauty as well. She has made this post about SLS. So yeah, I don't mind SLS, but if you are not comfortable with SLS, then you can go for this one. But even this one is quite good. And if you're looking for something with AHA or BHA, then you can go for this one. This is a cleanser for face, didn't work for me. This is Neutrogena oil free acne wash. It has 2% salicylic acid and it works really well for body acne if you have textured skin. It is a brand new bottle because I finished the one I had. Also, this Aha Glow face wash, it didn't work for me, so I'm using this on my body. It has glycolic acid, AHA. Also, it can be very good for as a body wash, but for my face it was too drying. Even this cleanser was too drying for my face, but for my body it's working fine. So we are shorted with body cleansers, right? Now I have body essences, and I didn't know there are like body essences, but lately I tried two of this and I was like, they're nice. So this is one from Centio. I think I pronounced the name wrong when I talked about this. These are from same brand and this is good. Body essence is something, this is very lightweight, you can use it, then after that you can use a like thick body lotion. But that's too much work for me because I already do so much for my face. Now if I have to layer my body care stuff, then though that will be a problem. But sometimes I do that at night. But you can use this in the morning, you know, when you go out during summer or the weather is very hot, you don't want something very rich, you can try body essence. And this is quite good. The texture is, see, gel like, almost like a gel moisturizer, and smells, I don't know how to describe this smell, but this is not overwhelming and it is hydrating, moisturizes my skin like well, not like a good rich body lotion or body butter, but as an essence it does a good job. So yeah, this is quite good. And it has few glycol, then some fruit extract, and it has paraben. I don't have any issue with paraben because I have debunked the myth of paraben many times on my channel, but if it is something that, you know, makes you uncomfortable, then don't use it, because I don't force my views or my comfort level on anyone. So that's on you. And another thing, another body lotion, sorry, body essence I have is this from Skin Food. I really like their packaging and this has honey extracts. I like their ingredients more and the texture is lighter than the Centio one. It is almost like a gel. Can you see it? Wait, this camera doesn't take focus, you know. No, you can't because it's sliding. See how it is sliding. Okay, so this is lighter than the Centio one, but again very hydrating, and it has few occlusives that can smells good. Okay, it has few occlusives that can prevent the water loss. These days I'm lacking body essences, to be very honest. I didn't think I'm gonna like them because I thought these are gonna be like too light for me, but they're good. So okay, next, what else? I have some gels after shave or before shaving. So for gels, you can use any aloe vera gel, any good quality aloe vera gel. I have been using this plum one. This is good, affordable, and I also use this one. Wait, there are like so many stuff, so it's kind of messy over here. All right, so sorry for that. Even the Innisfree one, it doesn't have much aloe in it, but I don't mind because if I'm using it before shaving and after shaving, I only mind if that thing is soothing enough for my skin, and it is. So yeah, I like this as a like pre-shaving or post-shaving treatment. And there's another thing, I didn't think I'm gonna recommend this to you because I was kind of skeptical. I got the small chota trial size before, and I kind of like it, and the ingredients are decent, and this is quite affordable, so I'm just recommending it to you. This one, this is a Vaseline's new rose water gel. I do not recommend this for your face. It has few fragrant components that can be irritating, but for body, why not? It can be good, you know. Let me explain you. See the first few ingredients. It has water, then it has glycerin, the second ingredient, then niacinamide is the third ingredient, which is very good. Then it has this texture enhancer, then we have paraben and phenoxythanol, so you know these things are preservatives. And the rose extract obviously comes phenoxythanol, so they are like saying that it is rose water gel, but it has like less than 1% of rose extract, so this is something you should know. But as a gel, this is kind of decent, you know, affordable. Like if you're using this for your body, I think it should do fine. If you're not allergic to this fragrant components like linalool, geraniol, I mean on your body. For my face, I avoid it. It smells like artificial rose, but not that headache bala rose scent, you know. It smells okay, and I think it can be good if you use a gel before shaving. Even after shaving, it may work for you, but after shaving I will stick to these things, and before shaving, if I'm looking for something, I'm gonna stick to this. But on body, to be very honest, it should be fine. But again, I do not recommend this for your face. I do not. I think it might cause, sorry, it might cause allergy. Not to everyone, but why to take chance where there are like better gels available for the face. But for body, can be good, can be really good. And I'm really impressed with the fact that niacinamide is the third ingredient, and that is one of the main reasons I'm recommending this to you. Okay, so now body lotions, and for that I'm gonna repeat those like my favorites, like all-time favorites, Aveeno, then what else, this Aqua Oat. These are, I love in the Bioderma Atoderm line, these things are my favorite. I have few other things to recommend you. So recently I found this one, Venusia lotion, and this is quite good. I mean, this is really good, very moisturizing, ingredients are good, but this is not fragrance free. Like most of the things you see in this recommendation, they are not fragrance free. I do not mind fragrance in my body care stuff, but if you want to avoid fragrance in your body care, then I can like make another video for you. So this one is good, very moisturizing, the ingredients are decent, it has butters, and I didn't know what is aloe butter, and there are people who explained it to me, and thank you for that. Good stuff. You're looking for something nourishing, non-sticky, yet nourishing, it can be the thing for you. So next I have Palmer's. Like Palmer's, they make really good body lotions. Their cocoa butter, if you have really dry skin, it can be very good, the cocoa butter. And if you're looking for something lighter, then no, not this one. Where is the other one? Oh my god, I think I finished it, you know. I had this Palmer's coconut oil body lotion, something like that. So this is lighter than this cocoa butter one, and that one worked well for me. So yeah, even you can try that. If you find this cocoa butter to be like thicker and you want something a little more lighter, then you can go for that coconut oil wala lotion. And this one is my like all-time favorite, their anti-aging lotion. Yeah, it has like fragrance that is annoying, but it has AHA BHA too, and it works. It really works. I use this like twice or four times in a week at night sometimes. So if you're looking for something with AHA, BHA in a body lotion, you can go for this one. I really want brands to make more body lotions with AHA and BHA in them, because we don't have enough. We do not have enough. Even maybe body toner or something like that, it can be very good for KP and all. So next I have this Himalaya cocoa butter. See, ingredients are nothing fancy, and it's okay. It has paraben, and like I told you, it doesn't bother me. It's totally safe to use paraben. It is like one of the most tested preservatives out there, and people have been misquoting one study, so please know that. And I found this to be kind of nourishing and everything, so yeah, I like that one. If you're looking for affordable body lotion that is nourishing, you can try this one. Even I have tried their their clear complexion brightening body lotion. This is good as well. It has niacinamide, and I really like niacinamide in my body care, my facial care. So if you're looking for a body lotion with niacinamide, you can go for this one. Or else, wait, this also has niacinamide. This is from Cetaphil, but this is kind of expensive, and I got like 40% off, so I bought it. And to be very honest, I'm not gonna pay like 1300 for a body lotion. I'm getting only 250 ml of stuff. So if you get discount, or if you want to spend your money on something like this, you can go for this one. This is actually quite good. It has niacinamide, few butters, and the texture is also quite good. If you use this religiously, then it can even out your skin tone like any other niacinamide based stuff. So yeah. And also you can use any baby lotions, like this one I liked very much. This Baby Dove, the smell is very soothing. This is very nourishing. I really like this one. If you are comfortable with using baby lotions for your body, go for this one. Even Johnson & Johnson Cotton Touch Lotion, I won't recommend this for face, but for body, it should be fine. Alright, so next I have this Nivea, their new Natural Liquid Lotion. This is the oat variant for dry to very dry skin. I like the texture. I think it is nourishing, but alcohol denant is the third ingredient. It has 6.1% alcohol denant. I mean, it's good they have mentioned it. And this denatured alcohol, it can be okay if it is formulated in a right way. And in this formula, it doesn't feel drying or anything for now. But when I apply this on my skin, I can like smell the alcohol, you know. And I don't know why I don't like it. And I have like other better options, so I'm gonna skip this one for now. But the texture is good, the ingredients look okay. I mean, okay, I think they are greenwashing it way too much. But if it is working for you, then it's fine. But not my taste. I have better options, like other things I've shown you, those are like better than this one. But the texture is good, texture is quite good, and I really found this to be nourishing for now. But this alcohol scent, it bothers me. It has, I can smell it, but it sinks into my skin very well. I think this is the purpose of alcohol denant. It gives very good texture, and it helps the ingredients and the product to like absorb into skin more effectively. This is why denatured alcohol mainly used for. So yeah. So lastly, I have these two lotions from Parachute, and I prefer their cocoa one more than these two. But I want to try like other variants, and this is their new, I think, this one, their honey. This is good, not that nourishing as that in the cocoa one. That's my favorite. I'm biased, but this is okay. And even this one is quite good. Their Deep Nourish Body Lotion, but I'd stick to that cocoa one. I like that one more. And even these things have paraben. I'm mentioning this because there are people like who are they're not willing to use paraben in their skincare. I do not want to force them into using something they're not comfortable with, but know this, we really don't have any reason to worry about paraben. But again, don't feel forced, like don't feel that I'm like forcing you to use something with paraben. So last, I have few body oil recommendations. I'm gonna be very fast because I'm kind of tired, you know, these days I feel tired a lot easily. So I tried this Palmer's body oil. It worked really well for me. I really like this, lightweight, it absorbs well, my favorite. And I tried this vanilla vibe from Plum. It works, but I prefer this one over this. And I don't know, I find it to be like kind of heavy, like for my taste in a body oil. I'm not that a big fan of this body oil. I like other things from this vanilla vibe range, but not this one. Like, I'm not gonna repurchase this, to be very honest. Also, I've tried this one from Sheer Secrets. They're deep moisture oil, shower oil. Not gonna buy this again. It's okay, but not that good, you know, not that nourishing, and the smell is kind of weird, I mean for my taste. And you can use any baby oil, like this one, Johnson & Johnson baby oil, or any oil. Himalaya has baby oil, I think, even other brands. And yeah, even I'm using one body oil and body scrub for this sponsored post, and I'm kind of enjoying those things. I'm gonna talk about it like soon. And yeah, I'm gonna make another video there. I'm gonna recommend more like body care stuff, like body sunscreens, things for KP, body butters. I have tried few body butters and I want to share those things. Body scrubs, and I made already a video on body scrubs. You can check it here. This one. All right, so yeah, but I tried this one from Dove as well. The Dove one is quite nice. They had this Rise body polishing scrub. Okay, I'm gonna talk about this in my like part two. And yeah, the things for KP and body butters. Body butters, I have very good recommendations, and I want to save these things for the next video. So yeah, that's all for now. I think I've spoken a lot about body care today, and you can see I'm kind of breathless. I know what's happening to me. I can see I'm kind of tired, but I really love to talk to you. I really love to be here. And someone told me that I might have this vitamin D deficiency. Yeah, I may have. I'm gonna get it checked very soon because I feel tired. Sometimes it's really difficult to breathe even, you know. But I really love doing this. I love talking to you, and I love making videos. And YouTube is my like happy space, you know. So that's all for now. I really appreciate you being here. Thank you so much, and see you very soon. Bye bye. Okay, so many stuff I have to now just clean the mess I have made right now here. Bye bye.